Hey all, welcome to Share Trek. This is Raj here. Friends, I have not been uploading any HIV content for a while because there is nothing new out there. And also, one has to have a balance in one's life, especially after retirement. So I am thinking that unless something new comes in, we shouldn't make any videos. And today we have some new information from Immuno Cure. Quite a few of the channel members had written to me saying they have brand new information. So I went through the whole thing, and what I have done is I have taken all the information and then created my own script to explain what it is. So we are going to start off with a recap of what ICVAX is, whether it's a therapeutic vaccine or is it a preventative vaccine. So we clear that up first, and then we talk about what were the results of phase one, and then what is the plan going forward. And in order to do this, in order to make the production much easier, I have fed my script to AI. So you're going to hear two characters. I would like to call them as Jack and Diane from John Mellencamp's song. So Jack and Diane are going to discuss my script. They're going to use the information in my script to introduce or recap what ICVAX is. And then they're going to talk about what the latest press release means, what is the phase one data and why it is encouraging. And then they're going to talk about what the next steps are with ICVAX. I hope you enjoy this. And when we have any more news, I'll come back to you again. The other more frequent question I've had is, what's happened to AGT-103? Well, we are still trying to do the funding, and I think that's what American Gene Technologies is trying to do so that they can start and finish phase 1B trials. And as far as EBT-101 is concerned, I am thinking that they are still working on getting a more effective delivery mechanism which can deliver the gene editing payload to all the cells and reach all corners of the body so that it can be effective. So the way I look at it from the previous data release, I'm thinking that the gene editing is working perfectly. It's just a question of making sure that it reaches all the target cells in the body. And once they manage to do that, I think they're golden. So that's the optimistic note with which I would like to leave you. And please stay back to hear Jack and Diane discuss ICVAX and the phase one release. And for people who do not speak English, the subtitles in around 10 to 12 languages will be out in a matter of couple of days after release of this video.
Okay, so get this. Imagine a future where HIV medication isn't a daily thing anymore.
Right.
And that's what we're talking about today. It's a potential future that this ICVAX offers. Mm. And that's what our deep dive is going to be focused on today. Mm. It's this like groundbreaking therapeutic HIV vaccine.
Right.
And it was developed by Immuno Cure.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to be exploring like how it works, what makes it so different, and all these exciting results from its recent phase at trial.
Yeah, it's really cool stuff.
Get ready for some like mind-blowing moments. And we're going to be unpacking a really fascinating article today. It's from the South China Morning Post.
Okay.
Which is a leading authority on news from China and Asia.
Right. So first of all, can you just walk me through what exactly is a therapeutic vaccine?
Yeah.
Because I feel like that's kind of counterintuitive.
It is.
Right. We always think of vaccines as preventing diseases.
That's right.
So how is this different? So you're absolutely right. Traditional vaccines are meant to prevent you from getting a disease in the first place.
Right.
But therapeutic vaccines like this, ICVAX,
right,
they're given after someone has already contracted the disease.
Oh, wow.
So in this case, HIV.
Gotcha.
And instead of preventing infection,
the
goal is to help the body control the virus that's already there.
Okay. So it's almost like giving your immune system like a boost.
It is.
Like a personal trainer for your T cells.
That's a great analogy, yeah. Because T cells are those white blood cells that hunt down and destroy infected cells.
Yeah.
And they're absolutely critical for controlling HIV.
Okay.
And ICVAX basically supercharges them.
Okay, so walk me through how it does that. Because the article mentioned something about a chimeric HIV antigen fused with a soluble PD-1 domain.
Right.
And I'm going to be honest, that sounds pretty sci-fi to me.
It does sound very complex, but essentially think of it this way.
Okay.
Imagine giving your T cells a custom designed weapon. and it's engineered specifically to target HIV.
Yeah.
And this chimeric antigen basically helps the T cells recognize and attack multiple strains of HIV more effectively.
Gotcha. So it's kind of like a super weapon then.
Exactly. Yeah, it's giving them the tools they need to really fight this virus.
Okay, so these supercharged T cells,
mm-hmm.
what do they actually do that's different?
Right.
Like, how does this actually work?
So the Phase I trial that was done
mm-hmm.
at Shenzhen Third People's Hospital
okay.
offered some really, really promising clues. And keep in mind,
yeah.
all 45 participants in this trial, they were already living with HIV
right.
and were already on antiretroviral therapy or ART,
okay.
which is like the standard treatment.
Yeah.
So what were the like standout findings from this trial?
Yeah. What really jumped out at you?
So two things really jumped out at me. One, safety,
mm-hmm.
and two, effectiveness,
yeah.
or what we call immunogenicity in the research world.
Okay.
So firstly,
yeah.
there were no severe side effects related to the vaccine at all.
Oh, wow.
Only mild ones reported.
That's huge.
That's huge, especially when you're dealing with a complex virus like HIV.
Exactly.
So yeah. that's a major win.
Okay.
And then in terms of effectiveness, the immunogenicity.
Yeah, did it actually work?
It did. The optimal ICVX dose
yeah.
led to a more than twofold increase in T cell responses.
Oh.
Which basically means the T cells were much better at recognizing and attacking those HIV infected cells.
Okay, that's impressive. Was there anything else about these T cells?
Yes.
That was interesting.
Actually, this is where it gets really fascinating.
Okay.
The enhanced T cells, they started to resemble those found in elite controllers.
Elite controllers, what is that?
So elite controllers
okay.
are these individuals who can naturally suppress HIV without needing RT.
Oh, wow.
So imagine harnessing that power with a vaccine.
That's wild.
It's really incredible.
Okay, so what's next for ICVAX?
So Phase 2 trials are set to begin in mid-2025.
Okay.
And these trials will include a larger, more diverse group of participants.
Okay.
And it'll expand to a couple different locations,
uh-huh.
like the Chinese University of Hong Kong.
Yeah.
And Guangzhou's 8th People's Hospital.
Okay. And what will they be focusing on in Phase 2 here?
So the main goal of these Phase 2 trials is to see how well ICVX can control the actual amount of virus in the body.
Okay.
What we call viral load.
Mm-hmm.
And this will give us a much clearer picture
yeah.
of its potential to actually achieve what we call a functional cure.
So break that down for me a little bit. What does functional cure mean?
So essentially it means suppressing the virus to such low levels that it can't even be detected by standard tests.
Wow.
And the person could live a healthy life without needing daily ART.
That's incredible. So like, zooming out for a second, why should our listener care about all this?
Yeah, that's a great question.
What's the real world impact here?
Right. Well, think about the 39 million people
yeah.
who are currently living with HIV.
Right.
For them, yeah. ICVX could mean a future. Free from daily medication,
right?
Free from the side effects
yeah.
that can come with those medications,
mm-hmm.
and free from the stigma,
of course,
often sure. associated with HIV. That's life-changing.
It really is.
And the potential impact goes even beyond individual lives.
Okay, how so?
Well, the HIV drug market
yeah.
is currently valued at over $36 billion.
Wow.
So if ICVX is successful,
right,
it could completely reshape this market.
Yeah, it's huge. Okay, so as we wrap up our deep dive today, any final thoughts to leave our listener pondering?
You know, I think the potential of ICVIX
yeah.
raises an even bigger question
okay.
about the future of medicine. Could this approach of therapeutic vaccines be applied to other chronic diseases?
That's a great question.
Could we be on the cusp of a new era where lifelong education isn't the only option?
Wow.
It's definitely something to watch as this field of research evolves.
Absolutely. Fascinating stuff. Okay, well, thanks for joining me on this deep dive today.
Thanks for having me.